a world full of enchantment, wonders, and magic.
Hi. Oh, how?
Where you are welcome to come as you are and stay to experience the magic by Pixie.
Welcome to the kingdom. We hope you enjoy your stay.
Alrighty, how are we all doing out there? I hope we're all having a wonderful week. It feels like a very slow week so far, but we're getting there, right? I don't know. I'm tired and I'm not tired, and I feel like I'm not entirely sure why, because I do and I don't know why. Yeah, I hope you're all having a great day, a great week so far. If you're just starting off the day, good morning. If you're just starting off in the afternoon, good afternoon, and happy good evening things, Bahabits, whatever. I am definitely in a really weird mood, I feel like, where I'm, like, tired, and I'm also, like, really, like, it's gonna be a weird one. It's gonna be weird. I can feel it. But it's also probably going to be weird because tonight we are doing Drawing by Pixie, and Drawing by Pixie can be one of two things, really, really cool or really, really weird. And tonight I feel like it might be weird because we're going to draw French toast. French toast. So, obviously, we probably need to explore the interwebs for, inspiration of sorts. So I might do that while we start the whole chatting it up type of things. So let's French toast. Obviously, we're going to need some Pixpiration slash also, like, maybe make us hungry the whole time, like, debating. This one looks really good, actually. I wouldn't say that that's French toast, though. It just looks like toast with some syrup underneath it, which I guess is the concept. It is a nice piece of toast. Yeah, I hope you guys are all ready to doodle along with me. If you are, I'm going to draw along with me. Whether you're creating something like I am or creating something completely different, make sure that you do join the Pix Cord. Let me pull that up really quick. The Pix Cord is a wonderful place to hang out and share some inspirational stuff. Something also that was really exciting today, like besides everything else, was I got a notification on Twitter and on Twitch today that made me so incredibly happy. Thinking of happy things to make me smile because this really, it made my whole day so freaking magical. As you guys know, we are raising funds for St. Jude. St. Jude is something that I love so very much because we raise funds every year for it. This is our third year raising funds for St. Jude. With St. Jude, our goal for this year is $500. We're currently $115 in, so a fifth of the way there, kind of. Math isn't that much strong, so I think it's over a fifth of the way there. And with that, today I got a notification on Twitter first that I got added to the St. Jude Play Live family on Twitter, which is like a list of other streamers and stuff that also play for St. Jude. That made me really excited. And then, as you guys can probably see right below my face, our latest follower is Amanda from St. Jude. And that threw me over. I didn't realize it until like right before I was setting up for stream. And I was just like, You're not crying, I'm crying. So that was really, really awesome and exciting. And yeah, I'm really, really happy about that. That was probably the best highlight of today by far. I think this is a really good picture. We're going to save this one for the French toast, brioche, whatever. And then we're going to look for a beret. French beret specifically. Thank you so much for gifting Amanda from St. Jude a sub in our channel. I appreciate that so much. You're very sweet. 50, you're like on a roll with gifted subs. Best in F5 now here. I feel like I need something like really obnoxiously French looking, and I think I found it. The noise didn't play. How rude. Hold on a minute. This way. Why the announce play? We're going to reset everything. And we're gonna try that again. Let me open up Streamlabs. Thanks for letting me know, 50. I appreciate it. Now, I don't hear anything. That did not come through at all. Kapow! Hello, Cajun! How are you? Hello, Mrs. Canuck, how are you? That came through. Did you guys hear it, or is it just me? Did you guys hear Goofy or no? I'm doing good. I'm just trying to figure out why we're having issues. You heard it? Okay, great. So I'm also gonna do this because being curious about it. You heard Goofy. Great. So we're back on track to being somewhat normal, I think. Or as normal as we can be, right? I also don't want this music to overpower me at all, so we're just gonna lower that quite a bit. If possible. I found a better way to do this. Alright. Is the music too loud? Is it overpowering me? Feel free to let me know. Because if it is overpowering me, I will definitely mess with it. But I thought this would be fun. I also definitely want this picture because I think it's exquisite. So, coming back in here for a minute, we're going to go live to this bit. we are also doing things all over the place. I am just like, I'm okay, I promise. Also, for those that may have missed the last few streams of me announcing it, the whole month of the January, we're in January, the whole month of January, we are running a sub-event where you can receive a free pair of ears from me. All you have to do is either A, sub at tier 3 this month, or B, gift 5 subs to our community. For the first 5 people that sub at tier 3 and the first 5 people that gift 5 subs, those 10 people will win a free pair of ears automatically from me. Doesn't matter where you are in the world, that is what we are doing this month. You'll get a free pair of ears from me. It's a pair of mystery ears, so you don't know what ears you're going to get. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. And yeah. Let's pick image slideshow. Sure, why not? We're going to do it where it's rotating. That would be... maybe not, actually. Let's cancel that. That's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. When you should probably figure out stuff before stream, but it's like, why would we do that? Ooh, look at that French toast! Oh, y'all, this is gonna make me hungry. I can feel it. I also am now wondering what happened to the sides of my webcam? What happened to my webcam? That's really weird. Everything's broken. We're gonna put these little French toasts in the corner, and we're gonna find our man with the beret that I found because it's, again, too exquisite to not use. Man with the beret. There you are, honey. Hello. Name you Pierre for the sake of it. All right, so there's our inspiration, chat, as we dive into our drawing for the night. I don't know, what do we name him instead? Did you not like Pierre? We can change it. 50, you're good at naming things. Paul. I think Paul. Paul, we can do Paul. I'm okay with that. I just shrug it off, told him I do what I can. I just shrug it off, told him I do what I can. Asian, do we approve of Paul? So please stay off my way. Niggas taking sauce and they act like it's okay. I just do my thing, so please stay up out my lane. He does kind of look like Paul Rudd, you're right. Plot twist. Paul Rudd did a film where he was French and none of us knew about it. Bayonet. To be like too crazy. I don't know why you get a racer when I have a gun racer. There we go. Paul is good. We like Paul. Good job, 50. I feel like I need a good job command. Don't know what it would do, but, like, good job, 50. Maybe just the utmost praise for John Paul? Like Sean Paul, but Jean Paul? Or is it Jean? Am I reading it too French-like? Meanwhile, doesn't really know much of French to begin with, so this is good. Jean Paul Rudd. Yes, 50, exactly. I had to try the Pizzle Pack because, like, I felt like these streams were just far too quiet. And I know for sure that this is definitely safe for stream. And we're not gonna get in any sort of trouble. This is too good. Not sure about this one. Really, like, in love with this one. Yes, that's where it came from. Pizzle Pack is what we are experimenting with tonight because I figured it would be fun. 50, have you acquired any new animals in your Minecraft adventures? Has there been any piggies or cows or anything? I really like the piggies. Debating on if we want to really tough, like outline it rather with the black Sharpie because I feel like it might be too harsh. But we'll find out. I rescued Chicken from the bottom of the cave. I remember that story this morning, yes. He leaped down a hole 2 days ago and I thought he was gone forever. Isn't it amazing how resilient some of the Minecraft animals are? You'd think they would have died. Because there was one time... Oh. There was one time when I was playing Minecraft and I literally watched... I don't know what animal it was. It might have been a llama, alpaca. What's the thing in the... Is it a llama or an alpaca? I don't know. But I watched it fall from, like, the top of a cliff once, and it still lived. I would be very deed. Like, very deed. Lampaka, fair enough. I feel like this has to have, like, a very swanky beret of sorts. It's got, like, a... I feel like we're drawing a baseball cap all of a sudden. At first I thought you were drawing the face, but then I realized you're drawing toast. Yes, I'm drawing. Welcome to the French toast stream, Keisha. The French toast. Long neck sheep. Yes, that sounds great, 50. I think that's the best one. Twinkie toast. Twinkle toast? What did you write? Twinkle toast. Twinkie toast. I wonder what that would taste like. Does anyone know? If you made like Twinkie into toast? Asking for a friend. I feel like this is like... Cannot be. Let's see. More pictures of toast. Oops, not toast, berets, beret, French beret. Got like a little bit of a lift to it. This guy's hat is like, turns out, I am not drawing the face. I am drawing the beret at the moment, but I'm drawing French toast. Hot Twinkie, it was not exciting. Hot Twinkie? What's a hot Twinkie? Yeah, he's got like this line that goes like this to kind of give it some dimension. It has a little bit of a fold in it. Wrinkles, whatnot. French toast with the hat, yes. So like, think of like, if I find a picture of what I'm thinking in my head, because I feel like I see this like little creature character. Not exactly this, but like related to this. Where did I save that? I don't know. Oh god, that's big. Welcome to the inner workings of my mind, where somehow this and this makes this. These are our inspirational pictures now. I have completed the trifecta. Yes. This is the thing that's been in my brain since last night, because I had a dream that we have our usual, like, every Tuesday, like, morning, afternoon, sometime of sorts. I asked the Discord, what do I draw tonight? And I had a dream last night that that happened. However, the dream was basically that y'all voted for us to do French toast, like, draw French toast. So, me being me, of course I'm going to share that in the Discord, and now here we are drawing it, which I don't say is, it's not a bad thing. I'm just happy that we're actually getting it off of my brain. So thank you for letting me run wild with this random brain thought. Deja vu. Deja vu. So, I think the idea, really, is that I definitely made this way too big, for starters. So, we're gonna try to bring this in a little bit, because his head is not as big, or his hat needs are not, they don't need to be like this. Why are you like this? Now it looks like he's wearing a sports cap. And obviously we're going to clean this up and make this a little bit better. Or as good as we can get it, for that matter. Thank you. I'm not sure if this is really going to get across like I want it to. I also feel like it really should be out further because of how much further it out is out from their head. And I feel like it would give that dramatic effect. What dramatics? I feel like too, it's gonna be different. I also don't think it should be this thick. There we go. Alright, so that's kind of like our toast and our beret. And now we're gonna figure out, I should really figure out how to flip this so you guys can see it the right way. That would probably help me immensely, wouldn't it? Is there a way to flip it? I think so. Filter? Found a way to make it brighter though, so that's phenomenal. But at least it's brighter. So yeah, we'll go from there. All right. So with our Frenchy French, what we'll probably end up doing. Up so I can see. We're gonna give him some swanky eyebrows because gotta be sassy. Not that this is exactly the shape that we're going for, but. So, I wanted to also run this by chat because this was something that I was questioning before stream because I had heard about this from a YouTuber who was basically saying that all people that are YouTubers, TikTokers, streamers, etc. were basically essential workers in this pandemic. And my eyebrow raised because I'm like, I'm sorry, I'm considered what? If I'm a streamer and I was full-time, I would be considered a essential worker. I'm like, that doesn't sound right. And it wasn't like anybody official. It was just a YouTuber basically trying to make the argument that those that are working in this kind of business where you're constantly online and in the public eye on social media and things like that, we have the right to entertain. And in doing so, that's why, you know, so-and-so keeps going on vacation to this place and this place and that place. And, you know, they keep taking deals to do X, Y, or Z stuff and they're not wearing masks and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, you're literally just trying to make excuses for behavior that shouldn't be happening in the first place. But all right, go off. Like, I don't understand why that would make anybody essential though. Like, even mainstream celebrities, a lot of them have been like, no, I'm gonna just hang back because my family safety and the people's safety around me are more important than me taking a movie deal or whatever the case may be. And some people are still working obviously and whatnot because it happens, but it's just like, I don't get it, dude. I just don't get it. Like, weirded me out that that was even something to, like, think about. Like, I understand people do this for a living and work full-time and, like, you gotta make your coin how you make your coin. But I don't know, I feel like at the end of the day, there's also the respect factor, and once we actually all are past COVID and past the fear in terms of going outside and things like that, because for me at least there's a fear, but I think majority it's like you just don't know what's gonna happen when you're out in public. I hope that people remember these things and make better choices in whose entertainment they focus on. But I don't think that's gonna happen either, because people have also like this like goldfish memory where they kind of forget exactly what's going on from minute to minute, which I think is also a separate issue in itself. The nose should be straighter because it's not gonna help me. I don't know. Let's find out. Making it this like spirally thing doesn't kind of give it some more textured feeling to me. I'm not sure how I feel about the nose yet. I feel like I should probably just make the nose straight so I could see the full mustache, because I think it's going to bother me otherwise. Here we go. No, I think that's kind of... Yeah. And then it's just kind of... And a butt. This is gonna be really weird, I can... I feel like we should probably color it in first before I outline it, just because I feel like that'll also help me and give me a different perspective this time about all of it, because I don't want to outline it and hate it. Not that I hated anything really in the past, but like I feel like this is a special piece. I also feel like ever since the biscuit offs stuff, I've been even more infatuated with Brett, and I think this is showing that. I'm gonna take out a tool belt of stuff. I think I'm gonna use the new twistables that I have, because I haven't tried those since I got them for Hanukkah, and I'm very curious about them. So we're gonna see what Crayola did with the twistables, if they made them better since the last time that I got them, which I still use them to this day. It's just, I think the color payoff could have been better in those. So I'm kind of hoping that these will be a little bit better in terms of that. But we'll see how it all plays out. I think what we're going to do is start off with a lighter color and then go in with some depth. Just because I think that'll save me, A, in the long run, and B, overall. But this is also why I probably outline it first, because I know I'm going to be annoyed if this makes it, like, run. So what I'm going to do, at least, is outline it in the black. Where are my... Oh, I know where they are.
Come back here.
Alrighty, we got our Sharpie. We're gonna put these twistables away for a second and we're gonna get into this. I'll put this down for a minute. We'll put that in Stitch's arms for safekeeping. Let's get into this. Part of me now wishes I had these in brown. I might need to go get a thin Sharpie collection. I mostly have thick Sharpies. I used to be really obsessed with those. I did so much with those. In college and the very start of my job, with posters and flyers and things, and different events. Sharpie has always been like a staple in my, like, art drawers. Like, if I don't have Sharpies, I don't know. I just think they're really wonderful. And they do a beautiful job. And something with this piece, too, is I don't want it to be perfect. Because it is a piece of toast, after all. Not meant to be perfect. It's gonna have some rough edges and things like that, so I'm not gonna beat myself up about that if it's a little bit wonky line work. Out there, whether it be traditional, digital, you work with different mediums. What did you create in the last week? Something you're really proud of. I was looking back on all of the Drawing by Pixies since we started them in October. And I feel more and more proud every time we do it, just because I feel like I can see my skills improving a slight bit, slash me actually letting loose and just letting the pencils and markers guide me in a sense, instead of thinking too deeply into it, which is my favorite pastime. I think what we're going to probably do as well is kind of give it a little bit of dimension, kind of like in the French toast picture on the bottom. It has a couple different colors throughout it and kind of and all that kind of stuff, so I feel like that'll be good to highlight and low light throughout. It's their Frenchy fringe. I like that. The hairs aren't meant to be perfect either, so that's also what I'm going to try to remind myself to go through shading of this one. Alrighty. And with that, we... Oh, I forgot his beret. How dare me forget the beret? Let's see. Dimension. I dig it a lot. Dug it. What am I talking about? There we go. Alright, so thank you for holding on to the markers. I appreciate it. We're gonna go through here. Did I say markers? I meant color pencils. Oh well. We're gonna try to keep his facial hair intact, but the rest of it we're gonna... Oh, I was dragging the pencil around with my hand. That makes a lot of sense. I'm like, why did the paper change colors when I did that? But it all makes sense now. Ooh, I just threw that. Hop into this. So with the beret, I might start there actually, since that's black and I know that's gonna be black. So start with the darkest color and then move out from there. I thought about making the beret a different color, but I really think the black beret would make me happier. Just because a lot of the clothes that I gravitate to are black in the first place, so I feel like this would be my style personally. And I think that was a good move by me to kind of give those accents in this black Sharpie, because I think that's only going to benefit passively, depending on how this comes out. Something. I'm giving it a little once over with the pencil a little bit more aggressively. I think is good. We're gonna find a lighter pencil that I found earlier. This would be better actually. Let's look at dark color. Thought it would be lighter than this, but for some reason I like it. I surprisingly really like it. Neato. Debating on also making his facial hair black. Part of me wants to make it like a dark brown color, but I'm not entirely sure. It might be getting lighter handed as we go further down, or it could be the camera. But I want to make sure it's pretty even for the most part. Try to add shadows and context as well. Not bad. I'm gonna find a darker brown and see how that outline enhances as we move forward. Is the brown? No, that's definitely a purple. Is there no brown in here? That's brown. Whee! So that's like a deep brown. That's some intense. I might bring that other pencil in to kind of like give it some life. So I'm not going to completely color that in. I'm going to leave a little bit of white space so that kind of like gives dimension there. Wee wee! And this might be the pencil that we use for the facial hair. We will mix this with black a little bit to give it that dimension. Paul Rudd is turning out pretty fantastic. Maybe I'll tag Paul Rudd on Twitter and see if he approves of it. Just for the sake of it. 50, do you think Seymour would approve of that? Me tagging Paul Rudd on Twitter and saying Jean-Paul Rudd? I feel like he might agree. Might be a good idea. Yeah, that definitely did something. That helped tremendously. Seymour definitely approves. Wonderful. As long as I have the support of Seymour, I mean, that says so much. Not many people get that, you know? We are doing the January sub-event where we are giving away a free pair of ears to the first 10 people who sub either A, 5 people that sub it, sub, wow.
Redler,
here.
Redler, and
hi! It's a raid! It's a raid! It's a raid! It's a raid! Resume your positions! Welcome to our stream. Hi, TB. I hope you had a wonderful stream tonight. I hope you had so much fun on the seas. I'm sure you conquered all of them. If you guys not know Tiger Beast is an amazing content creator here on Twitch. They are absolutely phenomenal in everything that they do, especially conquering those seas, like I mentioned before. They are definitely Pixie approved, and you definitely want to go and hang out with them. How are you? How are the seas? Did you find Jesus again? Tell me the things. Also, hi, we're drawing French toast. And like I was saying too, for those that just entered and for those that have just been here, we are doing a sub event this month where we are doing a free pair of ears with to the first 5 people who sub at tier 3 and to the first 5 people that gift 5 subs, 5 tier 1 subs in our chat this month. So definitely a really great and exciting thing. We're also doing Drawing by Pixie, where every Tuesday we draw something random and crazy, and this happens to be the one this week. We are doing French toast, literally, and having some fun. We do these once a week, and on the last Tuesday of every month, we raffle them off for charity. And this month, our charity of choice is St. Jude. We have a St. Jude fundraiser goal of $500. If we hit $500 raised, we will do something very special on stream. I'm still trying to figure that out, and you guys are going to help me figure that out too. And when it comes down to... I don't know what I'm eating, but I'll tell you when I return. Okay, sounds good. What was I saying? It's gone. I feel like I like the brow highlight for some reason. I don't know why. But we got rid of it. Yeah. I feel like the black will help give it some dimension as well. I don't know what it is. I feel like the swirling motion always makes facial hair look cool to me. Don't know why. This is a blur. They're not pretty, though. And a little guy liner, I feel like, but with purpose. So cute. Okay, we're gonna add some dimension to him a little bit. I really want to add in those like reddish flakes of sorts, like orangey brown flakes. I don't really know how this is gonna pan out, but it, like, we'll find out. Some dimension of sorts. We might completely be ruining it right now. We might leave it, actually. And I also might write here what the French toast. He came out so cute! I feel like that went way too quickly. Maybe we'll make a lady verse. Here we go. I kind of want to make another one. Just for the sake of it. And maybe make it a lady. With some lips. Some luscious lips. I really dig it. I don't know why. It's nice to see it actually come to fruition. I feel like if we make another one, it'll have a different color beret. I feel like it's gotta have similar eyebrows. Unless we just leave this be and we just make it a short stream. I don't know. That went so quickly. Maybe I should put syrup underneath them? We could put syrup underneath them. Might also be very weird, but we're going to find out together. Let's see what we can do. This might be a completely bad idea. However, gotta find it. Like a really deep maple syrup. We'll probably put some red highlight into it as well. I don't want it to look like it's floating either. That's kind of my other concern with this. I kind of want to make it look like he's standing. Thank you. Unless I should have it. Glimmering. Put the red over it. I do definitely think these pencils are like misleading sometimes. I think with the way that the twistables come out sometimes, in terms of like the opaqueness of them and whatnot, it's definitely a different color than I expect sometimes. And I think that's what throws me off the most. Because you expect one color, but then you end up with something else. Like, I feel like I'm not gonna get like an actual true red out of this. I feel like it's. Oh, I was wrong. I feel like this is now like a different kind of syrup altogether. Now it's like a reddish syrup, maybe like a strawberry syrup. Oh god. Yeah, I don't think that's the play. I don't think that's it. I feel like I should not have done syrup. That should not have been the play. I wonder if I could erase it. For the most part. Definitely not all of it. Experimenting sometimes is like a coin toss. You don't really always know what you're gonna get. Pulling the Sharpie back out. Wherever I put that, there it is. There we go. I feel like I don't know. I'm ruining a good thing right now, so I'll overdo that. Overall, he's definitely pretty snazzy, I think. I'm kind of upset about this now that I did that. But maybe it's just a shadow. And we'll call it a shadow. The time where Pixie drove herself nuts. It turned out to be a lot faster than I. Enjoy the French toast man like I do. I think he's really cute. A quick little drawing turned out pretty neato. He's super neato. I think what we might do is switch to a game because we finished early and I kind of really want to play Kind Words. So I think we're going to do that, if that's okay with you guys. Bring everything up here. This way. Here we go. And we are going to see what I could do. All of this and switching up. Put this all away. That took care of one essentially. Now we have two music tracks basically happening at once. All color in my face. Welcome to the stream where we try to fix it. Still, rainy. We'll get there eventually, guys. let me change the game real quick. Hope that's better. 50. Someone sends their thanks for the letter you wrote them. They sent a blobfish sticker. They gave you a mug sticker. Alright. So before we completely hop in, I'm going to go to the bathroom really quick and we will get things started.
Thank you. Alrighty, y'all, we are back at it. The camera's still kind of bothering me because I don't know why I look so washed out. Like, I really not sure. Make it too bright. I just don't know why it has that grainy look to it all of a sudden. Whoa. At least I look brighter in a good way to me. I don't look old and dead. I don't know why I brought that close for me. There we go. Let's try this. Let's just see what happens. Into the game now. So for those of you that might have missed it last week when we did Kind Words, when we did Snow White, basically the game is all about helping one another out. There's things where you can send paper airplanes in the sky, you can respond to people's requests, you can even make your own requests if you're going through something. I know this game has helped me immensely. My brother and I have played it a lot on his account. We haven't done a whole lot here yet, but we definitely will. I'm probably gonna send a request tonight because I could use a pick-me-up. I know going into the new year can be scary or uncertain, but it can also be exciting. I hope 2021 is filled with great opportunities and lots of love and laughter for whoever is reading this. Take care. I'm gonna say, what's something you do when you're I'm gonna write feeling down. Not that you are down. Feeling down. I feel like I need a new pick-me-up. You wrote a request. I will run this over to the post office to be copied and sent all over the world. We'll see what people write to us. It may take some time for people to reply. They might even send you a sticker. In the meantime, write something to somebody else. The nice thing about this game, too, is when you receive letters or, sometimes receive thank yous, like we got our thank yous at the beginning of the stream. Damn, you're looking fine today. I love stuff like this. This is like what did Donkey say? Was it damn that's a nice boulder or just that's a nice boulder? I think it was just that's a nice boulder. You're right, that's a nice boulder. Tried right on the wrong screen. That's a nice boulder. Here we go. Oh, I didn't mean to write it there. Oops. That's a request now. I meant to write it here. Whatever, we'll probably get some weird responses for that one. That was messed up. Overall, when I look back at 2020, it wasn't as bad as I thought. But I do hate that I don't get to visit my little sister who lives in another state.
now I'm scared I won't get to see her in person this year either. That's kind of how I feel with metal. I was talking to somebody about this the other day. When I look back at 2020, 2020 really wasn't as bad. Yeah, there was, you know, the whole pandemic, and it's still happening now. But I just really hope that I actually get to see my person this year, because I miss him. So I'm gonna write something to this person, like, whoops, not in caps. I can, like, have a link to this. There's someone special in my life that I haven't been able to see since March 2nd, 2020, because we both take this pandemic incredibly seriously. I would never want to put my loved one at risk just because I desperately wish to see them. However, I really do fear that this year will be very much the same as last year, in that I might not be able to see my person. But I'm not gonna give hope that there is a light. No, that I will see them. I'm gonna manifest it as hard as I can. I hope you do too. We got that. I'm gonna send the sailboat, because I feel like the sailboat with, like, the rough seas, I think that's really fitting. We can send it away. Thank you for taking the time to think about a stranger. I'll rush this right over. I knew you'd keep writing, people. I'm sure they'll love this. Oh hey, I discovered Light Garden this morning. I was a bit stressed about some things, but I put it on loop and washed all that away. Hopefully I'll have another sweet track for you tomorrow. Got new music. Neato. I've always looked up to girls. I thought they were way prettier than me, who met every societal standard of beauty. I still wish I was that girl today. I just don't have as much time, drive to do makeup and hair all the time, but I yearn too bad to look at the flawless models. I can also relate to this. I feel like throughout the pandemic, it's been really hard to be motivated to do much of anything. I basically wear sweatpants every single day. I wore jeans for the first time in a really long time on Saturday, and that was the weirdest feeling in the world because it felt so restricting. And I mostly only put on makeup for stream now. Which I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing that I do that. I feel like it's probably better for my face, so my face probably thanks me for that. However, I kind of miss getting dolled up more often. When we're stuck with nothing else to do other than scroll through Instagram and Twitter, we start to wish for to think we're lesser than, because we're not rocking a full beat. Full makeup look, because I hate the word beat. Full makeup look day to day, and we're not dressing up every day and yearn for that in a sense. I'm probably never going to be a model. Give my myself slack for sure. We're stuck with nothing else to do other than scroll through Instagram and Twitter. We start to think we're lesser than because we're not rocking a full makeup look day to day. We're not dressing up every day and yearn for that in a sense. I'm probably never going to be an Instabaddie of sorts because I would not be able to do that. But I know that I have to give myself slack for not wanting to do much of anything in the pandemic. I'm sure you're beautiful with or without makeup. Go find one nice thing in the mirror to compliment your skin on. Go to the mirror. Given the frog food. Alright. You can count on me to deliver this letter. Love is difficult and love hurts. Anyone that I've taken an interest in. Whee! CMC! How are you doing, honey? Welcome on in. We're currently going through kind words because we already finished our drawing for the night.
It went really, really fast.
But if you missed it... Raid alert! Oh my gosh, I totally missed it. Strawberry Shortcake, how are you doing? Thank you so much for choosing to raid us today. I appreciate that. Hi there, everybody. Thank you so much for choosing to raid me. Hi, Bobblecop Boy, how are you doing? Oh my gosh, error code, you too. Hi. Hi, Hazoka. Hi, Strawberry Shortcake. How are you doing? Thank you so much for choosing to raid me today. I appreciate that. I hope you are doing super well. I'm gonna give you a shout out. Oops. Thank you so much for choosing to raid me. I hope you had a wonderful stream. How was Control? For those of you that might be new here, my name is Pixie. I am a variety streamer here on Twitch. We were just drawing right before this. We drew, what's the French toast is what we're calling it.
I don't know if you're gonna be able to see that because the light is like super weird today. But yeah. I don't know.
But yeah, we drew this guy. And now we're playing Kind Words. I'm doing really, really well. Kind Words, for those of you that might not know, is an indie game made by Pop Cannibal. It's all about mental health and taking care of one another. Currently, we are writing letters to some people. We wrote a request earlier, so I wrote two requests, one by complete accident, so I'm curious what's going to happen with this one. Hopefully it's a response to the first one. But for those of you that don't know this game and you feel like you might need a pick-me-up or something that, like, can help you through some really tough mental times, this game is, like, my tried and true. I love this game. And I hope you guys enjoy it, too. So before I wrote, what's something you do when you're feeling down? I feel like I need a pick-me-up because I was kind of feeling pretty down. Welcome to my kingdom, Chevy boy. I hope you enjoy your stay. How's your day? Thank you so much for choosing to follow us today. And Kindred Spirit P wrote, finding a small new hobby is one of the best things for that. I've recently gotten into tarot and crystals. Tarot sounds so much fun. And I really would love to get into tarot card reading. I have no idea what that really entails. I've had my tarot cards read before, but I have no idea. Crystals and smudging, and it makes me feel more at peace when I can just take a moment to look over my cards or charge my crystals, buy a new scent of incense, or collect flowers to press, try new things, and find something new that you enjoy. Even if it's small, it helps. That's kind of how I feel about drawing. Drawing has really helped so much. Kind of get through the pandemic. I feel like it's been something that's been really nice to just kind of pick up and do and go. When it comes down to tarot cards, though, I would love to get into it. I don't know if anybody here does tarot cards. But if you can give me some insight on it, I would love to learn more about it, or figure out how to really get into it. I know there's a few tarot card readers that I really love here on Twitch. Scarberry and Dalt Wisney do an excellent reading. I love both of their styles of reading. I really appreciate them for even doing that. Once a week, I think they do that. I think Scarberry does it on Saturdays, and Dalt, I think, does it on Sundays. And it's super great. Maybe that's something I'll do this year. I'll get into tarot. Alright, what's the next one say? I got a sticker! Drooper! We got to add a new decoration to our room, guys. Alright. I'm not sure what you mean, but thank you. This was the accident. I meant to put this in the air as a... That's a nice boulder. I'm just gonna send them like a derpy thingy. I hope they like the sticker for answering that silly question. What's something you do when you're feeling down? I feel like I need a pick-me-up. And Kindred Spirit Z wrote, I often put music and just play Stardew Valley for a bit. Stardew Valley seems to be like really picking up again. I remember it being really popular, I want to say like a year or two ago, maybe longer. It's been a while since I tried it. I didn't really love it the first time I played, and I think it was because of the situation I was in at the time. So I'm willing to give that a try again. I know I still have it on Steam. I just have to kind of find my way into it. Alrighty. Let's say thank you with a sticker because I almost forgot to do that. Give you the little... I appreciate that, Chubby Boy. Thank you so much for choosing to hang out with us in the first place. I really do appreciate it. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and I hope to catch you next time. Enjoy your lurk. Alrighty. Let's go back. Someone censored, thanks for the letter you wrote, and another bowl sticker. Did we get another letter already? Or is that the one I already opened? Oh yeah, I did get another one. From H. I found it a little boring the first time, but they are in the midst of adding new stuff. I heard a new beach area is being added. Is that to Stardew Valley? Because I don't think there's a beach in this game, so I'm assuming Stardew Valley. I found it like really boring. I could not get into it. I understand that it's like a chill game and it's meant to relax you. I feel like I need a little bit more energy. And sometimes I really need chill stuff. Like, this game is super chill. There's not a whole lot of energy to it other than the deer makes me super happy. Yeah. Super weird. Alright, so something that this person does is journaling. Start with just the stream of consciousness. Put how you feel on paper. Don't think too much about it. Too much as you write. Then look at it objectively, find something positive that you can take from it, or path forwards to growth. End your entries with those. Remember to be kind to yourself and others. That's also really nice. I do like that. We're gonna say thanks with a sticker. I think what we're gonna do is a little kitty face. Always cool. Alright. We can back that up. I can keep the train a-flowing. I have issues with moving too quickly in relationships, and I screw them up. Met someone great over the break, and I admitted my feelings to them. I know they don't feel the same. I knew things would change, but now I'm struggling with the consequences. I'm gonna just refresh something. For some reason, everything is moving super slow, and I want to make sure that I can actually read what's happening. Our bitrate is taking a total nosedive. That makes a lot of sense. We are dropping a lot of frames. Which is super weird.